actually an excerpt from a long poem I've been working on and off, and it's from The City. The city is full of sexy young things, and the buildings celebrate their love, blinking in time with the murderous sky. It is time to do drugs with people made mostly of feathers. It is time to turn a key in the door of the city that opens to noise. The city never reaches maximum capacity, and all the people love each other profoundly, in a way that connects their fingertips invisibly but not imperceptibly, giddy and undeniable as the settling of air on your tongue before a tornado. Some people in the city do not have fingers, but antlers instead, or quiet streams of mist, and feel their feelings in places that are strange and beautiful and beyond what medical journals can't identify. There is a place that loves each of us how lightning loves the stupid wet dirt, in which a downright slutty number of lives are wildly possible.
Yeah, I like that one.
Thanks. All right, this is a pretty new one, pretty recent one I wrote, and it's called Sweat Church. Dressed in the night and downing a spiked gas station Coke in this body I want is my salute to Cassiopeia, sitting up there self-immolating like a real lady. The Chinese place advertises iced tea now beneath its fluorescent dragon, and I affirm the urgency. Summer not guaranteed to be the season you die in. How many sky bodies know what it means to be thirsty? Buzz, I'm a beast of light running through aisles of corn like a secret kept from the farmhouses. Continuous weather patterns shine the greenhouse windows. Newborn moths race the first star, shrugging off ghost skins to the ground. What can be broken apart will get broken apart and become two new things that feel in themselves a raging union of muscle and spirit that can withstand anything. And those things are right until they are beautifully not. The last poetry reading I read at, most of the people there, like, have literally, I don't think, any idea that I or anyone else that was reading poetry was reading, so that's nice to hear applause. Like, oh, cool. Alright, so I wrote this poem for that reading, which is on the 4th of July, and it's called Hands of America. First we're gonna build a barn, and then we're gonna shoot a goat. A big goat with big-ass horns that can tear you open unless you shoot it first. Why do you think I brought it up in the first place? Next we're gonna lay down a couple stretches of highway with four dealerships all up and down it. Those little red, white, and blue triangle banners all flip-flapping from the light poles, and after that it's remodeling the KFC. The South will rise again. A 12-piece bucket, only $12.99. Lick your fingers and get over here and hold this large piece of metal while I attach it to another piece of metal with fire. Put your other hand over your heart while the round man in a silly hat plays a sad trumpet. Good. Now which horse do you think will win? Recent gallop poll or no-fault dip horse? Either way, the local weatherman never ages. Now make a fire with these two sticks without quoting Castaway. Now chop the head off a snake with a shovel. Now fry a burger and give it to a team playing sports. Who here is a team? Who here knows a team? Look around, see what being a team does to our communities. Volunteer to scrape teens off our highways or feed teens to the less fortunate. Maybe even go door to door with scary pamphlets talking to friends and neighbors about the dangers teens pose to our country. Then shave that hippie beard and get a real job that doesn't involve kissing baby deer on the mouth. That's what we call hard work in American first class, achievement, elbow grease, pedal to the metal, balls to the wall, go big or go home, run derby, guitar solo, freedom toast, self-made man of steel-toed boots, hunk of burn in the midnight, oil ingenuity right there. Now go grab your daddy a Bud Light, City Slickers is coming on.
Woo!
Dangerous spark. Don't go when they talk about your little paper house. not already make you tremble. Ryan shows me old mattresses wrecked by love all along the highway, and I mouth what Christ taught me, blame softly, when we fail to regret our wrong and hungriest moment. All the horses are dying without knowing they're dying, and I pity their fear of the unknown. These clothes are unnecessary. The sun is not embarrassed. My heart is a sleeping deer about to be awakened. I think that's what I mean. Wake up. Don't reason with a plane crash. Clean up the fucking bodies.
Woo!
Fierce kingdom of kites.